So, you've built a few agents, they can perform certain tasks, but now you're wondering, how do I actually allow my clients to use them, right? What can I do to integrate these agents seamlessly into my or my client's business? And the answer is always, you need to deploy them. Your agents must not only be reliable in terms of their performance, but also in terms of their availability. Even if you had the smartest employee in the world who could do anything for you, but if it took her 1 hour to respond to each message, then probably she wouldn't be so useful, right? And the same goes for AI agents. So, this video is divided into two parts. In the first part, we'll explore the theory of AI agent deployment, covering all the options available to you. Then, in the second part, we'll walk through a practical example deploying an AI agent in production using the exact template that we use in our AI agency for the cloud deployment option. Let's dive in. Okay, before we get started, quickly about me. My name is Arseny, and I built one of the most popular AI agent frameworks out there called Agency Swarm. And it allows you to create AI-powered agencies that can serve other businesses and automate complex processes. By the way, I also have recently renamed my channel to my full name. Now, let's go over the fundamentals. First of all, what is AI agent deployment? AI agent deployment is the process of making your AI agents accessible to your users. Essentially, making them available whenever you or your clients need them. Okay, makes sense, but now let's unpack this with a couple of examples. If you are running your agent locally on your computer, is it considered deployed or no? Many people would say no, but it actually can be. Like, for example, last week we released a new repo called Agency Swarm Voice that allows you to interact with your agents in real time. Currently, it does not support cloud deployment, but the thing is, it doesn't have to, because the primary use case for that repo is personal assistance. So most likely, it's never going to be used by multiple employees at the same time. Each employee is going to have their own personal assistant running on their own computer. So in this situation, it is considered deployed because it is already usable in its own production environment. Now, let's take a look at the second example. Say you have an agent that you are running in a cloud via API. Is this agent deployed or not? Well, again, it depends. So if this agent is supposed to be used primarily on backends, so if the users of this agent are going to be interacting with it via API, then it is considered deployed. However, if this agent is primarily intended for your team, who is not very technical and they don't even know how to make an API request, then most likely it's still not deployed. So the point is that the agent is deployed only when it is accessible and usable for its intended audience. Only when the target audience can interact with this agent seamlessly without any barriers can we truly say that this agent is successfully deployed. Now, why does AI agent deployment matter so much? Well, the first reason is because user experience is key in making AI agents useful. I often say in our school community that integrations are more important than functionality. If it takes an hour to get a response back from the agent because it's hard to access or requires complex setup every time you run it, then the amount of value that your users can get from this agent will be severely limited. Secondly, a suboptimal deployment approach can lead to significant issues further down the line. There are a lot of factors like scalability, data privacy, costs, and more that you need to consider because getting even one of them wrong could derail your entire project. For instance, accidentally sharing your client's data with third parties when your client has strict data policies in place could lead to serious legal issues, something we definitely want to avoid. So typically, there are three primary challenges that developers face when deploying AI agents. The first one is not having enough technical experience. So simply not understanding the technologies involved in the process. The second and perhaps more dangerous one is not knowing your options. because even if you don't have enough technical experience, you can always ask ChatGPT. But if you simply don't know your options, then you don't even know which questions to ask. And lastly, not understanding the trade-offs in the context of your own project. There's rarely one choice fits all, and ultimately the best deployment option will heavily depend on the context of your project. So you need to clearly understand the trade-offs between all of these to select the most optimal one. All right, so now let's go ahead and review all of these options in detail so you can avoid all of these costly mistakes. The first deployment option is local deployment. This involves running your agent locally or setting up your own server. The pros of this approach is that you can make your system fully private, where no data ever leaves your own private network. Additionally, you have complete control over the environment. The cons of this approach is that the system needs to be kept online constantly, and scaling such a system is almost impossible on your own. As your user base grows, you'll need to always buy more hardware, reconfigure, and manage it yourself. I generally recommend local deployment only when clients are using agents locally with personal assistance or for large enterprises with enough existing hardware in place. The second option is cloud deployment. This option involves deploying your agents in a container in a cloud. A container is like a box that packages all your code, libraries, and settings together. You can easily move it between different providers without having to reconfigure everything from scratch. Essentially, it helps you to avoid "it works on my machine" problem. The primary advantage of this option is balance between scalability and flexibility. You have enough control over the environment, and you can easily scale it with the help of services like Google Cloud Run, Amazon ACS, or Railway, which, by the way, we'll be using at the end. The cons of this option is that you'll have ongoing subscription fees. So although cloud deployment is quite robust and it can work for the majority of use cases, it really shines for large-scale external applications where you might have thousands of active users. We'll go over some project examples shortly, but for now, the next option is serverless. With serverless, instead of deploying agents in a one big box, you have multiple smaller boxes where each box represents an individual service, like, for example, a tool, an agent, or an entire agency. The main advantage of serverless is its elasticity. Because each function scales independently, you are not charged when your agents or tools are not being utilized. And the costs for serverless are also significantly lower compared to cloud-based option. So, for example, for 1,000 tool executions or 1,000 agents executions, on average, you would only pay a few cents. However, it does have some limitations. First, you have restricted execution time, typically up to a few minutes. And secondly, you have less control over the environment. So, for example, you can't run any super heavy packages like a Chrome browser in a serverless function. I recommend this option for internal projects with a smaller user base. The next option is SaaS deployment. This means deploying your agents on a SaaS platform where you don't have to manage any underlying infrastructure and don't even have to think about any scaling issues. So with SaaS, there's obviously a lot less technical experience required, but of course it does come at a cost. Not only financial, because most SaaS platforms overcharge you tens to hundreds of times per token, but also in terms of flexibility. I personally receive partnership requests from these platforms weekly, and by now I have tested over 20 of them. Still, I couldn't find any SaaS product that we'd use at our EA agency because none of them provide enough access to the underlying agent configuration, and most of them don't even allow you to write your own prompts. So I recommend using SaaS-only option for very simple projects or MVPs. And the final option is hybrid. This is a new emerging option that we discovered at our AI agency. You see, we found that oftentimes it's not the agents, but the tools that need complex setup. So you can mix and match different options we talked about earlier. For instance, you could run agents locally but deploy tools in a container, or you could deploy agents in a cloud container while keeping tools serverless, or you can keep your agents on SaaS while tools in the cloud. So this approach lets you to balance the trade-offs between each deployment option to truly find the most optimal one for your specific use case. Now let's go over some common project examples, and then we'll also select the best deployment option accordingly for each, so you can practice your understanding. First, imagine you are working with an enterprise client who wants to automate their sales process by generating meeting summaries, performing lead research, and then combining all of this information into well-crafted emails. However, they have strict data privacy policies, so none of this information can leave their internal systems. In this case, you typically deploy on-premise. However, keep in mind that many enterprises also use Google Cloud or AWS, so the cloud option typically will also work if you can ensure that their data never leaves their own cloud environment. And in case if they can't use OpenAI, I suggest going with Azure OpenAI, which ensures that your data is not even shared with OpenAI itself. Now, what if you are building an external SaaS product like a fitness coach to help people create personalized workout plans and keep track of their macros? In this case, you might choose the cloud deployment option because this allows you to tailor your environment to your own unique needs and scale it to virtually any number of users. Unlike serverless, cloud deployment also supports streaming, which is one of the key features for user experience in external applications. Check out my previous video in the description if you want to learn more about streaming in OpenAI API. Now, let's say you are working on an internal project manager agent that onboards new clients and can handle common inquiries in your shared Slack channel to help real project managers save their time. In this case, I would recommend hybrid or serverless options. So since it's an internal project, most likely it won't be used at all times, like for example, when it's nighttime in your client's time zone. So to adapt to variable workloads, you typically want to deploy the agents in a serverless function or only the tools and keep the agents on a SaaS platform. And in fact, this is the most common project type that we receive in our AI agency. So personally, we always go with the hybrid option, except when our clients have super strict data privacy concerns. So unless we are working with a very large enterprise client, we always deploy tools in a container, in a cloud, and agents on our SaaS platform, which gives us a perfect balance between flexibility and control. We have a playbook and an exclusive template for this in our community, so check it out if you're interested. If you prefer not to use SaaS at all, then for most projects like this, I'd still recommend deploying agents in a container using a modern service like Railway. So although it is a service for container deployment, it also provides you with serverless options and simplified management. All you need to do to deploy your agents is literally just hit a button, and then Railway will automatically manage and deploy everything for you. Anytime you push a new change to your repo, your deployment will automatically be updated as well. So the template for this will be available in the description completely for free. So now let's go ahead and let me actually show you how to use it. So here's the template which we use at our AI agency to deploy agents in just a few clicks. The setup is really simple in this repo. The prerequisites for this repo are simply Python installed. Docker is optional if you want to test Docker locally, although it's not necessary, and also fully tested agency. So for this deployment template, you already need to have your agency created and fully tested for a specific use case. So if you still haven't ever made agents with agency swarm, then check out my previous video on how to create agents using Cursor without writing a single line of code. After you have your agency, then the next step is to simply click use this template. So click create a new repository, then name your repository, and then click create. Okay, so now that the repo is cloned, let's copy the link and then let's go to GitHub desktop. So in your GitHub desktop, simply click clone repo and then insert your URL. Okay, now open your code editor. I'm going to be using Cursor, and then simply open this new folder. Right, cool. So as I said, the setup is really simple. All you need to do is simply add your agency inside the SRC directory. So let me quickly copy my content agency that I created in the cursor video. Okay, so I'm just gonna copy the entire agency folder, then simply paste it right here. After that, you can also remove the example agency. So simply move this to trash. And then you will also need to replace the import inside the main.py file. So here in main.py, simply replace example agency with the name of your agency folder. So for me, it's content creation agency. And then also ensure that the agency.py file actually has your agency variable exported. Also, don't forget to change it to relative imports. So simply add dots for all your agent imports inside your agency.py file. After that, just a couple more steps left. First of all, we need to install the packages. So simply hit Command Shift P or Control Shift P on Windows, then create virtual environment, select your Python, and then hit OK. Additionally, don't forget to copy the requirements from the requirements of your agency into the requirements of the repo inside the SRC file. So let's wait until the squiggly lines disappear. And now the packages are successfully installed. So after that, simply copy .env.example file and name it into .env. In .env, you will also need to add two variables. The first one is your OpenAI API key, and the second one is your app token. So simply generate any random password for app token and then insert it like this. This is going to serve as your API authentication token. Okay, so this should be it for setup. Now only the last step before we can deploy it is to test it locally. So open your terminal, then navigate into the SRC directory, and here simply run python main.py. Okay, now we get this URL with port 8000, so simply open this in your browser, and then at the end of this URL, add /demo-gradio. As you can see, now we get this agency interface with Gradio, which is running on our server. So all you need to do here is simply say hi or something, just so we can generate the settings.json file. So if the agent responds, it means that your agency is functioning properly. And as you can see, now we have this settings.json file inside SRC. So this is actually quite important. You have to add your settings.json file in your repository, because if you don't do that, your agents will be recreated every single time your users use your API. Right, awesome. So now we are basically ready to deploy. So let's simply hit commit for all of these changes. So add your commit message, like added content creation agency. And then simply click commit and push. Right, so now let's actually deploy it on Railway. So go to railway.app and then on your dashboard, create a new project. Then select deploy from GitHub repo, and then select the repo that you just created and click deploy now. So that's basically all it takes. The only last step left is to generate your URL and also add your environment variables. So go to variables tab right here, and then for each variable that you added before, simply create a new variable name and add your value just like this. Okay. So now hit deploy again to apply the changes. Then let's wait until our new deployment is finished. In the meantime, we can also get our URL. So go to settings and under public networking, simply hit generate domain. And for the port, if it wasn't detected automatically, just select 8000. All right, so now our deployment is successful. So we can navigate to this link and then simply add demo gradio path just like this. So now, as you can see, it will open the gradio interface. But the difference is that you don't have to run any local commands anymore, and this Gradio interface with your agency will always be online. However, the most important feature of this deployment template is actually not the Gradio interface, but the API. So there's also an API endpoint for you at Path API Agency. It's not gonna work from the browser, but you can test it with Linux or PowerShell by running the following commands. And with this API, you can essentially connect your agents to any other systems. So for example, you can follow our tutorial on how to integrate this agency in Slack, or you can connect it to a tool like Zapier and essentially connect it to any other apps where you want to integrate this agency. You can, for example, connect it to something like Google Chat, and anytime there's a new message in Google Chat, you can run this API through Zapier and then send the response back to Google Chat. So that's it for this video. Thank you for watching, and don't forget to subscribe.